Now the last thing, and that might be shocking for some of you, that is, Juma actually is meant only for an Islamic state. What we are offering as Juma, strictly speaking, from the point of view of fiqh, it's not Juma. Juma is only in Islamic state. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't offer Juma in Makkah, although the five obligatory prayers had started. And in Baitul Arqam, Muhammadur Rasulullah and his companions used to pray in congregation. But Juma only in Medina. And let me quote here, that is why during the British Raj, British rule in India, there was a big controversy whether we can hold Juma congregation here or not in India, because now it is not Darul Islam. It is Darul Kufr, it is Darul Harb, because we are being ruled by the Britishers, non-Muslim. That is why four rakat were added, and that was called Ihtiyatul Zuhr. That if you are holding Juma congregation and you are saying Juma prayer, you say four rakat of Zuhr also. Because if that view is correct, that the Juma here is not permissible, then actually you have lost your Juma also and Zuhr also. Juma, because Juma is not permissible here, and Zuhr you have not prayed. So to make up and compensate for that, it was advised to the Muslims to offer another four rakat Ihtiyatul Zuhr, because actually in Islamic society, Islamic state, Juma, and secondly, Juma is to be controlled by the Islamic state. There is a hadith that only the Amir or the Mamur, he should deliver a sermon. That is why there was a controversy in India, and there is controversy in many other countries also, whether Juma can be offered and held in villages or not. There should be some town where some important government official is present, and he is to lead the prayer. The Amirul Mu'mineen used to lead the prayer in Medina. The governors used to lead the Juma prayer in, you know, every capital of the province. Then in smaller divisions, where the district or the sort of that, the deputy commissioner, who is there, the chief person, you know, administrative authority, holding the administrative authority, he should lead the prayer. This was when, you know, Islam was one. Religion and state were not two things. But later on they separated. And today what is the condition? Now this has become more or less a ritual. But this ritual is very important, still important, because it is like a weekly meeting of the Hezbollah, of the Islamic Revolutionary Party. They join together, they gather in a mosque, and then actually the function should be, the basic purpose should be the teaching of Quran. يَتْلُوْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ. But I have referred to this, you know, jurisprudence, the issue of jurisprudence of Islam, that actual Juma, real Juma, we can say it is simple Juma. It is something similar to Juma which we are offering. But the real Juma will only be an Islamic state, where the persons who are holding office, who are holding authority, offices of authority, they will be leading the Juma prayers. Otherwise, you know, Allama Iqbal has said beautifully, قوم کیا چیز ہے قوموں کی امامت کیا ہے اس کو کیا سمجھیں یہ بیچارے دو رکعت کے امام. We have imams of two rakat, and mostly, you know, especially in our countries, there's no respect for these imams. These people are thought to be, you know, they are servants, they are being paid. They are actually the heads who are governing or who are managing that mosque. They have the say in the affairs. The imam, the poor person, he doesn't have any say in the administration of the mosque. So actually this is not the condition, ideal condition. But still it is beneficial. At least we are gathering, at least we are listening to sermon. Some of the knowledge of Islam comes to us. It should continue. But please note it, that all these things are not to the full reality of Islam till that date that we establish an Islamic state, and the real caliph, he leads the Islam, the prayer of congregation of Juma, and he delivers the khutbah. You can well imagine the khutbah that the head of the state would be offering and delivering. The khutbah that the governor in some province will be delivering. That would be sort of a policy statement of that government. That would become the press conference for that government. That is actually the basis, because there the state and religion become one. This dualism and duality disappears.